Okay, today we're going to be working on a 97 Pontiac Grand Prix with a 3800 Series 2 engine. And so that's a V6 3.8 liter engine. And we're going to be doing a fuel filter replacement. And the fuel filter is located right here between the door and the left rear wheel. And just sits just a little bit inboard on the inside wall of the frame, and you'll find it right there. And we already raised the car, set it on jack stands as always, and I also placed the pan underneath the fuel filter to catch the fuel that will leak once the fuel filter is detached. And we have our regular safety equipment on hand, a fire extinguisher. Whenever we're working on a fuel system, we want to make sure we have at least a BC rated fire extinguisher on hand. So next, we want to start the engine and remove the fuel pump fuse and let the engine idle until it stalls, thereby effectively relieving the fuel pressure before we remove our fuel filter. And once the engine stalls, you want to turn off the key, place it in the off position, the ignition key, and then we want to disconnect the negative battery terminal. That would be the negative battery terminal. We want to make sure we disconnect that. Whenever we're working on the fuel system, especially on the fuel system, we want to disconnect the negative battery terminal. We want to make sure there are no sparks or any ignition sources. And we want to be working also in a well-ventilated place with no ignition sources, no one smoking, and having a BC fire extinguisher on hand. And here's a shot of the filter. And I used a 5/8 inch open-end tubing wrench and a 13/16 open end wrench, and it's a little loose, but it works. It'll probably be a 20 millimeter or 21 millimeter. I'm not sure which one. Didn't have one with me, but the 13 inch works with a 5/8 open end or tubing wrench. And also, it's a good idea prior to removing the filter to use some penetrant on the connections to make it easier to remove. And next, we'll remove the fuel filter support. And I'm using a 13 millimeter socket and ratchet. And once it empties, I usually let it empty, and then I just place it back in this place and just screw in the bolt a few turns so I can remove the rear connection to the filter. And the rear connection to the filter It's held only by a squeeze type connector, and I'm going to see if I can do this by hand, with one hand. You squeeze on the tabs and you pull that hose back like so, and there will be more fuel leaking out. And when you do this, you want to have the new one ready, because usually that continues to leak. So you want to have the new filter ready to go. And next, we'll slip off the fuel filter support from the old filter. Get ready for the new one. And we'll slip the fuel filter support on the new filter. Next, we'll slip on the fuel filter and keep track of there's some holes on each side where the clips would go. This clips on the press clips on the filter, they snap right into place. And then we'll adjust our bracket. So make sure it fits. And then we'll adjust our bracket to make sure it fits. Easily, making sure that the tube can go in and sit fully into the filter here. And then just place the screw loosely and thread in your fuel connection. Make sure it goes in straight and you don't cross the threads. And once we thread it in by hand, then we're ready to time it. I want to make sure that fits nice and easy, loose, it's not binding. Otherwise, adjust your support. And we'll tighten this up. Then we'll double check our connections. Make sure the rear connection is fully seated. And then we'll finish tightening our support bolt. Then once we finish tightening our support bolt, then we're ready to double check that everything is connected correctly, that your connections are tight. Now we are ready to reconnect our fuel pump fuse. Put back our fuse box cover. And now we're ready to reconnect our negative battery terminal and start our engine and check for leaks. And I think that'll be it for this video. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this video was helpful, and please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. And as always, try to stay clean.